Somebody has wronged us. When God think about us, and he don't think about how you sin. He don't think about how you potted, how you fornicated. He don't think about how someone who has dealt in molestation has molested somebody. He don't think about the homosexuality. He don't think about the lesbianism. Amen. And once they go and they repent, amen, of their wrongdoing, God forgives them and he forgets about it and he casts it away. But see, our thought process, we hold on to it and we carry it and carry it and carry it like leather luggage. Don't want to ever set it to the curb and let the garbage man get it, amen. Yeah. Some things that we are thinking about, amen, in our thought process, see, from day to day we think about, so much goes through our mind and every thought ain't pure. That's why the Bible tells us that we should always and often repent of our sins, because even in our thinking, we sometimes sin in our thinking. No, Pastor, I didn't act it out, but it crossed my mind. It's just sin, baby, it's sin. Our thinking is what gets us caught up, gets us trapped up in situations, amen. See, as we begin to think, amen, and all of this goodness, we got to realize that we're not thinking like God, amen. See, and another thing that I realized about, our thoughts are driven by our emotions and circumstances, amen. Sometimes, amen, now I've even heard people say, they put on certain attire and they say, well, I'm feeling sexy today, and they got a whole new walk, they got a whole new talk, they got a whole new lingo, amen. And sometimes, amen, they'll hang with a whole different group of friends because today they're feeling sexy, amen. See, driven by their emotions, amen. Some people are driven by the circumstances, amen. Just because things ain't going right, things ain't going well, I don't feel like that. If I'm at work, they say misery loves company, amen. I'm miserable today. Gosh, you're gonna be miserable too, amen. If you working in my environment today, you may as well get ready for misery, because my misery wants some company, amen. And whatever it takes today to get my misery satisfied with some company, I'm gonna do it, amen. If I got to mess up what you got going on, if I got to tell a lie on you, if I got to bring you down in some kind of way, my misery is gonna get some company, amen. I'm not gonna sit in here all day by myself and I'm gonna be the only miserable thing. They say when you frown alone. Everybody gonna have a frown before the day over with. If I got anything to do with it, because I see, I already thought about it on my way to work. I'm not this type. I'm not the person you hire, boss. You don't want to cross. Now this man got the right to fire you, and you don't want to cross me today because I'm not the person that sat down in the interview, amen. I got something going on, amen. I was cut off in traffic. Somebody flipped me a bird, amen. You don't know who I am today, amen. See, sometimes when we're going through, it changes our character, is what I'm saying. And we're thinking differently. We are acting differently, amen. Nothing can be done to satisfy us until everybody in our little area feels the same way we do, amen. And then you know what? I found out that sometimes when people get you down, when they get you bothered, when they change your way of thinking, now you're thinking like them. They get off in their own little mind. Here they go. Now you don't see it because they got the whole image, amen. But they're laughing, they're sniffling. Anybody ever pulled a prank, amen? You couldn't bust out and laugh, but you laugh within yourself, amen. The misery is over there laughing because now you're miserable, amen. Oh God don't think like that, church. Can you imagine God waking up? They say never sleep, never summer. So can you imagine God waking you up and God not having a good day? Can you imagine God waking you up and God ain't feeling it today? Can you imagine God waking you up and he just don't pistol? Huh? Can you imagine if God acted like we act? If God thought, I'm not having a good day, and they think that the loan is going to go through today. They think that they're going to get the new car today. They think that it's going to be a sunshine. It's a beautiful morning, but given 30 minutes, just because he bumped his toe, it's going to rain on your parade. Come on. It's going to rain, amen. Somebody says showering down blessing, but no, this ain't no blessing this time. Things are beginning to happen in your life, amen. Things are going wrong, but not to say that God is having a bad day, but even when he allows it to happen, can you still trust him to be God and trust that he's still thinking, amen? He's thinking all the while you're going through
A lot of times when we're going through, we don't even have to mess with it. All we need to do is go through, prepare ourselves, girdle up our loins, stay in the word of God, stay before the face of God, and go through. We ain't got to put up our fists, amen. We ain't got to go and work out for the challenge, amen. We ain't got to keep running to the bank, running to our mother, running to our father, trying to get a loan. We don't have to do that. We just have to stay up before a God that's thinking about us, amen. Listen. It says, in 2 Samuel 7:19, this King David was looking over his life and all God had done, told him, you know, blessed him with and done in his life, how God brought him from tending to the sheep, amen, to being the king over the palace, amen. And all of this right here, David said to God, and yet, this was a small thing in your sight. Oh, Lord God, and you have also spoken of your servant house for a great while to come. Listen, God's been speaking over you folks from the foundation of the earth. God's been thinking about you from before your mother and father even got together and got you. God's been thinking about you. God's been thinking about, they say this saying that he's the Alpha and the Omega, which leads me to believe that he knows what's happening in the beginning. And as we go through life, amen, as we travel life's journey, he knows what the end is going to be, amen. And David said, this is a small thing for you. See, God don't think like we think. See, when we think, we thinking about just us. And see, when God looked over David and was thinking about all David is going to become, from the sheep to the temple and all that David was going to become, God was also thinking about you. And wow. You. And you, see, we can't put too much stuff on our mind, because if we begin to think too much, amen, we begin to get confused. We begin to mix names up. We begin to mix this up. We just get confused. It's too much to retain because we are not God, amen. Now listen, not saying that you can't come close and know what God is individually thinking about you. Now, it ain't your worries or problems to know what he's thinking about me. Because see, I got to stay in line with what God is thinking about me to get to where God is calling me and to do his will, amen. Glory. Hallelujah. God is so good, amen. Now listen, verse 20 says, now what more can David say to you? For the Lord God knows your servant. It's because he knows you. When you're going through, he knows you. When you're having the hard times, he knows you. He knows you. That's how he can stay, you can stay on his mind. He knows each and every one. Say, God, come the stars, and he can call them name by name. And guess what? Each and every one of his children, he can call name by name. He knows us, and he can call us name by name, one by one, and name by name. Listen, God's thoughts, Jeremiah 29:11 say, the Lord, for I know the thoughts that I think toward you, said the Lord. He said, they are thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. To give you an expected end. Listen, now we as parents, as we begin to have kids and everything, amen, and we began to think about what our kids going to be, and as they get into a certain level of maturity, they began to plan out and think about their life, amen. But the most important thing that we as parents and we as children that are planning our lives, amen, to get in contact with a God that's already got the right plan, amen, that already got the right thoughts, amen. He said he had plans that are good and not of evil. Sometimes, amen, since our thoughts are driven by emotions and circumstances, it leads us to sin. Right. It leads us down the wrong path. Right. It leads us to destruction. It leads us to be separated from God, amen. But the plans and the thoughts of God brings us closer. Right.
and closer to him, amen. He don't have no plans that's going to do you any harm, amen. If you go on life's journey, amen, and you're doing your own thing, and all, you're always into this and always into that, stuff that are leading you away from, I will change my way of thinking, amen. See, the one thing that I found out, amen, in life's journey, in order to know more about what God is thinking, amen, in order to stay in tune with what he's trying to do in my life and take me where he's trying to take me, amen, that I had to change my way of thinking. I had to do a renewal process. And I had to trade it in and say, I'm trading, changing this life of mine, amen, from what I used to do. I'm changing it to what God wants me to do. Why? Because his thoughts of me, toward me, are good, but not evil, amen. His thoughts of peace, amen. I was listening to that minister Felicia when she was testifying, amen, how she began to talk about what she was going through. And she said, again, amen, going through it again, amen. When you're going through it again and again and again and again, and when the same thing keep on happening, amen, can you remember God's words? Okay, though the clock break down, can you still hold on to it? He got plans of an expected end. When the kids are doing wrong, amen, can you remember that God still got plans of an expected end, amen? When your finances are jacked up, amen, can you remember that God still has plans of an expected end? He said the plan wasn't null and void just because you began to have a little turbulence in life. That back then, you call back the plans just because things got a little shaky. That didn't make me say, oh, I ain't thinking about you no more. He said, even the more, even when you're going through, my son, my daughter, just know this. You are always on my mind. My thoughts have never changed. I'm constantly thinking about you. I still have an expected end, amen. They say that there's a place called there. And I believe that place is the expected end, amen. When you get there, amen, you will know it. When you arrive to that place called there, you will know it. When you get to that expected end, you will know it. Ain't nobody can tell you, can tell you or tell you where God is trying to take you. When you get there, somebody say, when I get there, I'll know it. Listen, because I believe that the way is laid out. Uh-huh. The path is, it's kind of plain, but it ain't always smooth, amen. That's why we run into those rough spots and rough areas where God is standing saying, can you still believe me? You say you're my child. See, his children, amen, have his spirit. And with them having his spirit, they ought to believe what daddy say, amen. And we his children, amen. See, if you was a parent that constantly lied to your children don't believe you. Uh-huh. They'll get with one of the siblings and say, mom and daddy telling another lie. Uh-huh. Why they lie so much? why they just can't tell us what the deal is? See, 9 times out of 10 when a household is going through something, kids already know that there's something going on in the household, whether it's finances, disagreement, and this, that, and the other. So you can't really lie to them, not today you can't.
Right.
Now, back in the day when they stayed outside in the yard and played, instead of the day when they stay in the house on the internet, you probably could have got a little something over them because they wasn't in the house to find out. But they're always in the house nowadays. They know everything that's going on. And listen, soon as one pastor say, heated testimony began between husband and wife, amen, you got one that's going to stand in a little secret place and hear everything. So you can't lie to God. You can't lie to him. Nah, it ain't gonna work. Not today. It ain't gonna work. Because see, now, you know, you're trying to tell them about God, and then, you know, a couple of days ago, you was telling them a lie. They're wondering, where is your God? What God? What God? Is God, this expected end of God bringing my parents to lie? But God is so awesome, amen. But he's saying all of this in his word and through testimony, amen, that no matter what you're going through, no matter what happens on life's journey, if you're my children, God said, I got you. I got you. I got you in my thoughts. You're always on my mind. You're always on my heart. No matter, I don't care because sister so-and-so, brother so-and-so, a whole congregation are professing to be the children of God. I got them, but
Just know that I got you. Amen. I got you. You're always on my mind. Yes. You're always on. I never sleep. I never, even when you're sleeping, I'm thinking about how I'm going to get you out of this. Not that he's thinking because he knows how I'm going to get you to this expected and how I'm going to, what God is saying. What am I going to place in your life to convince you to get back on the right track so you can get to this expected end? I love the Lord. I heard he heard my cry. Even when I was doing wrong, amen. And how many of you know that even in wrongdoing, things will happen, God will call. And the first thing you happen is, oh God. Speeding down the road and you look back and see the red and blue, you say, oh God. Then you get a ticket. So I got pulled yesterday. I got pulled yesterday because I didn't put a tag on the vehicle. The tag was laying on the floor. So when he walked up, he said, oh, it's right there. Just let me run your license, amen. And see, how many know that God knew I didn't put that tag on the vehicle? He had to create something, just like he will create something in your life to conform. See, we got to obey the laws of the land. If we're his children, he commands us to obey the laws of the land. That's how we get to our expected end, amen. You can, if God is calling you to be a great evangelist, a great, person of God, causing you to be someone that's traveling the world, and you are disobeying the laws of the land and end up serving life in prison, listen, your world is right there on the count. You ain't traveling. You ain't catching a jet every day to be where God is calling. Your life is right there on the count. So we must obey the laws of the land in order to get to the expected end. See, God has, this is a great journey. I don't care what we go through, sis. I don't care what may happen or how it may look. See, it's not even about how it may look. It's how the end's going to look. And I love Brother Kenny say, if you read it, or just go to the back of the book and you can believe that everything you didn't read, we win. It's an expected end for you and I. And can I tell you, it's great?
Yes.
It's a great end. Amen. Everybody stand on me.